Do students really need to spend 7 hours a day learning?
Boys and girls, may I have your attention, please?
This Texas school might have found a faster way.
Do you mind if I time you on
this
one?
Sure.
And hit it.
This is Byron. He and his classmates complete all of their academic work in just 2 hours a day, yet place in the top 2% on standardized tests. But it gets even more interesting.
This is probably the most shocking thing is we don't have teachers.
This is a school where AI reigns supreme.
They're going to learn math from Albert Einstein, civil rights from Martin Luther King.
This feels like something you'd see on the Jetsons.
But can AI really turbocharge student learning?
How do you know that each of these kids are all learning what they need to be learning?
That's the beauty of a personalized education system.
Education is ready to be disrupted. The problem that we have in our traditional school environment is that most kids are bored, struggling, or checked out. And so we wanted to see if we could do school in a better way.
I'm like so excited.
These kids are boldly going where few students have gone before. But there's more going on here than just AI. Because if two-hour learning works, what does that mean for the rest of the school day?
In order to be a great learner, you have to be a motivated learner. And so the rest of the day is where the magic of our model really comes alive.
This is Stand Together Presents, stories, ideas, and advice from changemakers tackling our biggest challenges.
That's not fair, children. Wait until you're called on.
What did you not like about a traditional school experience?
Having to sit there and follow along with everybody else.
You know, teachers have been given an impossible job, the primary of which is trying to transfer knowledge to kids that are at widely variable levels of understanding.
Kathy, now remember, give Kathy a chance.
Kathy takes too long.
And I think back to when my oldest daughter was in second grade and she came home and said, I don't want to go to school tomorrow. School is so boring. And at that moment, I just realized the model of education was broken. The traditional public school system really hasn't changed in over 100 years. It's a teacher lecturing in front of a classroom, and that style of education doesn't work.
All right, wait a minute. Do we really know that?
Because I imagine sort of like the comment section online, it's so controversial.
It is, but learning science shows that the best way to educate a student is one-to-one. And unfortunately, there is no way that a teacher can provide that to 20 plus students in a classroom. So I decided it was time to exit that traditional system and start my own school.
Now the hard part, how to provide every student with one-to-one learning. McKinsey thought AI might finally be the answer, but would others agree?
Do you think that a robot teacher could take the place teachers you have?
I got a group of parents together who were willing to try this great new experiment. And what we found is we could use an AI tutor in order to provide a one-to-one personalized curriculum in only 2 hours a day.
But why 2 hours?
The traditional classroom experience is so inefficient. We don't need the whole day.
We do math, reading, language, and science. We work 30 minutes in each subject, and it's self-paced learning. So, for example, I'm in sixth grade, but I'm working in seventh grade math.
And as a result, our students are learning twice as fast as students in a traditional classroom.
And then the afternoon is really the fun part.
All afternoon, they're learning life skills through workshops.
And that's kind of a key to our motivation model. Time back to go do the things they love.
We're coding self-driving cars.
Making pasta.
Dragon's breath.
We're managing an Airbnb. And so far, we have $10,000 of confirmed bookings.
Really? Wow. What was that experience like?
I mean, understanding all of the aspects of buying a property, financial literacy, management, that's something that can be really used no matter where you go into, since the point of it is to become more independent.
We focus a lot on skills that our young people need to go out and be successful in the world. And then they're able to do these really big things.
I am building an AI-safe teenage dating coach.
I am creating the first Broadway musical that's entirely written and performed by teenagers.
And I'm building a self-improvement community that fosters ingenuity and creation.
I've always been interested in engineering, and I feel like all the life skills and workshops unlocked that opportunity because it taught me that even if it's hard, If I stick with this long enough, then I will figure it out.
And while there might not be teachers, there are adults around to redirect kids in case they get stuck.
More and more, the world's moving to a place where you have to be an autodidact, and these kids are learning how to train themselves.
We have transformed the role of the teacher to do what they got into the business to do, which is connect, motivate, and help students figure out that intersection of their passions and their talents.
They're going to be master leaders, they're going to be master facilitators, and they're going to be very capable.
I'm excited to see what they do in the future.
So what's next? In an effort to address demand and cost, Alpha School is opening new campuses across the country, while also working to make their model financially accessible to as many students as possible across all learning environments.
We've created kids who genuinely love to learn, and the results are there.
I think a lot of students, they just don't know what true level they're at. And when you find out, then you're like, oh wow, I'm a lot better than I thought I was.
We're showing that every student has the ability to be a confident, capable learner. Every student is capable of rising to a really high standard.
3, 2, 1!
Kids are limitless. And it's our job to provide them with an environment that helps unlock that potential.
Stand Together partners with changemakers tackling our biggest challenges. To see more stories, follow our channels. And to learn more about how you can partner with us, go to standtogether.org.